A little bit. Well, a man charged with reckless homicide has pled not guilty. LMPD arrested Zachary Amasher on Friday after he was in court yesterday morning. Police say 4-year-old Zacharian Depp was killed in an accidental shooting at a home on South 37th Street last month. While in court, prosecutors detailed what led up to that shooting.
Defendant reported to officers he took the handgun from his waistband, placed it on the couch, and attempted to conceal the handgun from the victim before he exited the room. A short time after the defendant left the room, he heard a gunshot. He then found the victim suffering from a gunshot wound to the face.
A judge set Amasher's bond at $10,000, and he is expected back in court on Monday, February 12th. A Meade County man has also been charged with murder after police say he used an AR-15 to shoot a woman in the face, killing her. It happened Thursday, just outside of Brandenburg. According to court documents, someone called 911 and told Meade County Dispatch, quote, "Dad's gun went off, mother has been shot." Deputies say Derek Ford was arguing with the victim when he picked up the gun and pointed it at her. Court documents also say Ford pulled the trigger, shooting the woman in the eye, killing her. Ford's bond is set at $250,000, and he is scheduled to be back in court on Wednesday, February 7th.
1, 2, 3. Rest in peace, Raymel!
Raymel Atkins would have been 16 years old this week, and yesterday, loved ones returned to the corner where he was killed last fall. They held a balloon release in his honor after he lost his life to gun violence last September. Police say Atkins was shot multiple times inside a home on Galbraith Avenue. He was taken to the hospital where he later died. 4 months later, his case remains unsolved. Atkins' mother remembered her son for who he was and promised to continue fighting for justice.
This was his whole neighborhood. All of these kids is the neighborhood. And it saddens me for him to be in the same neighborhood all of these years to get gunned down on his front porch. He would have been getting his permit, ready to get a job. He had been talking about a job since he was 13. That would have been the main thing. He would have been, "Oh, mama, I'm ready to go work."
Anyone with information on this shooting is asked to call the anonymous tip line 574-LMPD, or you can go online and use the online portal. Well, the suspect in the Delphi murder case has a new hearing date. Richard Allen is due back in a Fort Wayne, Indiana courtroom on Monday, February 12th. Allen is accused of killing 14-year-old Libby German and 13-year-old Abby Williams back in 2017. On Friday, one of Allen's attorneys filed a motion asking for a continuance. Brad Rossi claims that the hearing was scheduled without consulting his office on his availability and says that he's going to be out of town on personal matters. Prosecutors are accusing Rossi and Allen's other attorney, Andrew Baldwin, of violating a gag order. Rossi says because of these accusations, the February 12th hearing should be moved to give him time to prepare to address these accusations and to hire an attorney himself. Back here in the metro, the LMPD has seized 40 guns off of Louisville streets. Police say a recent investigation from detectives on the non-fatal shooting squad led to the seizure of the weapons, plus narcotics, cocaine, and meth. The investigation is still ongoing and police are unable to give any more details. They say they'll give an update as soon as they can. Well, it was a top 10 showdown between two of the SEC's oldest rivals, UK and Tennessee. And this morning, the Cats are recovering after a very tough loss. WHAS11's Kent Spencer and photojournalist Sarandon Raboin report from inside Rupp Arena.
103 points. It's the most points ever scored by Tennessee in Rupp Arena and the most points Kentucky has given up in an SEC game since 1992. The Vols punched the Cats in the mouth from the opening tip and Kentucky could never get off the mat.
We just got to keep coming together as a team and stick to the game plan. We got to talk and I mean we're going to be okay, but we'll continue to get better and be more physical and communicate better.
Is it an effort issue on that end of the floor?
To a certain extent, it definitely is an effort issue because, like, even though some players don't go out there and they purposely not go for the ball, not effort, but, like, it's just, like, the ball is there and we're not going as hard as we can, you know, because we don't really want it. So it is an effort. Like, you got to really want it. And I don't know if everybody wants it, but I feel like we do.
I haven't lost any faith. We don't have DJ. I mean, teams are playing good against us. And all our goals are still there. I have a good team. We're young. We still make some errors, but we got to get healthy.
Next up for the Cats, they hit the road to take on Vanderbilt on Tuesday in Nashville. Reporting at Rupp Arena, Kent Spencer, WHAS 11 News.
And coming up later on GMK, Mason Horodisky will have more highlights on that game, plus U of L versus FSU and IU versus Penn State.